We're really pleased to have you here, especially after your brilliant performance at the International Court of Justice hearing in Ukraine-Russia case. Dead Lawyers Society has been following closely this process. And we understand that you're limited in your answers, but maybe just about the emotions. What did you feel when you are representing a country which has been a victim of aggression in the International Court of Justice?
Well, obviously, it's a huge honor to represent Ukraine for the International Court of Justice. We strongly believe in the claims that we've brought in Ukraine's cause. Of course, these claims aren't about the aggression specifically. They're claims under two specific treaties, and we are confident that we will prevail on those claims.
Thank you. This belief is enlightening for all of us. And in terms of transition, you have a great career in international commercial and investment arbitration, but the interstate judicial process, is it any different in terms of legal techniques, in terms of maybe oral advocacy?
That's a very good question. It is a bit more formal, it's a bit more diplomatic than, say, a commercial arbitration or certainly a municipal court proceeding. And I think you see that in the way that the proceedings are conducted. The videos are available on the ICJ website. It's a much more controlled environment. The advocacy tends to be in the form of prepared speeches, and there's you are given a lot of room by the court to make your points, not interrupted by questions the way that you would be in a court proceeding. So that does make for quite a different preparatory process. Not necessarily a lot easier, but you have to worry less, I think, about being prepared for every conceivable question you might get.
Next question will be, maybe any advice that you would give to young Ukrainian lawyers which are only entering this world of international dispute resolution?
Well, I think the process starts when you're at law school and doing your studies. If this is an area that you're interested in, then certainly you should take the classes in the area. I'll put a plug in, I know that you'll be pleased with this, for the JESSA competition, which is something that I competed in as a law student, and which I would say taught me more about public international law than anything else I did at law school. It was hugely enjoyable. And then I think it's all about just trying to work your way into the right firms that have this sort of international advocacy, and being clear and determined that this is an area that you would like to work in.
Thank you so much for having you here, and I hope that you will prevail in our case. Thank you.
Thank you very much.